looking at the velocity of roller coaster. And one other question. So it's one of the special days again. No, do not know why to clip. You eliminate the outer cell and just go into the inner juicy core. So, for the lesson.
Can you post it as chat from the website?
Start from over here. So, let's say first we have a starter hill. And then there's another hill that goes back up. So there's like a valley in between. So there are two points that we need to know. So here is point one. V1 here is zero. Thus, KE1 would also be zero. Here, V2 is some unknown number, but PE here is definitely zero. So first, you want to find this unknown number. Next, there must be somewhere on this first hill where it gains half of the velocity it has here.
So what do we have to find, Professor? Can you write it down?
Wait. We'll find it. So this is what we're going to call each point. Okay. So we will.
What do you need to find, Professor?
Okay. So first we will need to find V2. So using the law of the conservation of energy, E1 is E2.
Which one is E1? Which one is E2? Can you write it down?
Here is point one, here is point two. Look.
Oh, I see.
So, that would mean PE1 plus KE1 plus PES1. There's no swimming behind the scene unless it's a very dangerous roller coaster you're talking about. And then P is also equal to zero. No, K is equal to zero. And let's say the height of both hills is 40 meters. The height of both hills are 40 meters. So PE2, KE2, PES. Okay. So here PE is zero. There are no PES, please. So that would give you MV8 one equals to half MV2 squared. So now we can actually
isolate V.
Yeah, now we can actually find
the square root of 2GH.
Yes. So.
Professor, can I calculate it?
No. I know how to do this. So 2 times 40 times 9.8. So that would give us 784. Root 784, I memorized it 28 exactly.
That's correct.
Yeah, same thing.
That's correct.
Okay, now we know V1.5.
That's correct.
This point is going to be 14. So wait, what height is this? So we can find it by using the equation backwards. V1.5 equals root 8 times root 2V8.5. Actually, we'll call this 1.25. So if we square both sides, we get this. Okay. So now solve for like that, and you get V1.5 squared over 2G. That gives you 196 over 19.6, which is always exactly 10. But wait. This is 1.25. You must subtract it from the total height. And 40 minus 10 gives us 30 as a final result of the height here.
Wow. So how do you do it? Where did you do it?
Okay.
Oh my God, where is it?
Okay.
Why did you decide to do it there? I'm completely lost. You have all the spaces on the left side.
There is so much empty space.
This is that here? Okay, let's do this all over.
Are you out of your mind, Professor?
Sorry. So V1.5, we can use this in reverse. So we square both sides. And this is what we get. So 2g. So that gives us 196 divided by 19.6, which is 10. Exactly 10. But this is 1.25. So we have to subtract it from the total height, h1. So 40 minus 10 is 30, obviously.
So what do we have to calculate?
The height. Well, so which we just calculated.
10 meters. No.
30 meters.
30 meters.
Subscribe to Bari Science Lab to fall in love with math and science, especially programming.